I'd say about horizon on the 10-degree line, 2 minutes prior, huh?
10-degree line. You got double line?
Well, I have double line on the 30, so I can use that as a head position device and then look down the 10.
They're not parallel? They assume we're in eye position?
No, I'm saying is on the 30 degree, I have both panes of glass.
Yeah. Okay, but if you line those up, then is your eye in the right position for all the others?
Yeah.
Okay.
Being.
What's the shaft and trunnion numbers?
1511.
What?
1511-357.
We're a long way from being there, Neil. We're rolling over at a very slow rate.
Okay.
You want to expedite? We got a lot of
gas. No.
I'd be happy to zip on around me. This thing's taking forever to get around here. We got 20 minutes to check. I think I'll speed it up a bit if you don't mind.
We got one ten. Report what it is.
Yeah,
2 10.
You know, if you hit this hand controller, like you do in the simulator, minimum impulse, just bang it. It'll bang over and bang back, and it'll fire two opposing pulses, and you get nothing. Thank you. Oh, shit. Got a yaw out 14 degrees. Hell, the 90 there. I read that number wrong. Yeah, there, it couldn't be 1.4 degrees yaw.
That one gets moved over so far.
Yeah, the goddamn one in this computer, you know, is trunnion angle, it's there, delta V, it's there, angles, it's there. Probably over here for something, although I can't think of what, but there, there, and there, and there, of course. There's four places. Okay, we're there, Neil, by the time you can get down here and get your eyeball out the window.
Hey, what's those numbers again?
We'll crank them on the computer.
I got them.
Question the accuracy of the computer? Okay, satisfied with that?
Give me the numbers.
1519 CMC optic zero off. We're 41 now, 91.
You mean after I went to all those work of cranking those numbers in, you're going to drive back to zero?
We got program alarm and an operator error. Right.
Give me the numbers. 1519 and what?
He won't pass that number. 1511. 357.
357, okay. Three, five, seven, and 1511. There's supposed to be a star there.
That's right. You put them in the right order. A 1511 is that.
Yep. I've got a star in the section.
Good.
It passes. Let's press on.
Not sure it's Zena.
Good, no way of telling. It's, you got 16 minutes to take. Did it pass?
Optic zero.
Optic zero and manual. The mode's manual already in it. Okay.
All right, we're 3740 Anna.
Okay. Okay.
Mag mode 3 to rate 2.
VMAG mode 3 to rate 2.
Spacecraft control CMC auto.
CMC auto.
Proceed.
Well, we proceed with the trim.
Huh? Aren't you getting a trim or not?
So no. You like this?
All right.
Let's not proceed.
All right. Now, why? Line spacecraft roll. Already there. DDP alert.
Okay, that's a good one. One standby one, I'll get that. Okay, GDC in line.
Circuit breaker, stabilization control, final exit. Closed.
Stabilization control, circuit breakers are closed.
Okay, SCS circuit breakers. 8 of them closed. 12 of them closed.
SCS. 12 and close. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 close. Okay.
Not a
Say again?
I lost my trip. At dead band minimum.
At dead band minimum.
Rate low.
Rate low.
I'm going to cycle off.
Okay.
9-3. Rate command.
Manual attitude 3 to rate command. They are.
B-mag mode 3 to rate 2.
B-mag mode 3 to rate 2.
Okay, control power direct 2 of Mach.
Okay, off.
SPS CDC 2 to rate command.
Rate command, rate command.
CDC gimbal drive 50. And yard auto.
Auto, auto.
What's the time?
We have 12 minutes to go. Helium valves auto and barber pole.
Yeah, I'll get there.
Yeah, I'm just wondering if they were. I'm not questioning the checklist, but just out of curiosity. Yeah.
After the burn?
Sounds like a good idea. Let's look at the moon after the burn.
That'll give us a high gain.
Good. Okay, 10 minutes will take. Temperatures are deceptive. I don't know where they're measured, but the cold point in the loop. Okay, sunrise. Now, 10 minutes prior to shade, I should have the horizon in the 10-degree line, or?
No, 2 degrees. 2 minutes.
2 minutes. That's more line right there. Not all through this COAS as far as steering it, I mean, you know, you'd be hopeless.
I think it's 6 months ago.
And I'm graphically reminded of it at this moment. I see a horizon.
It looks like we are going forward.
Gauge of Gemini.
It is most important that we be going forward.
Oh, no.
There's only one really bad mistake you can make there.
Hey, the Gemini retrofire. Are you sure? No, let's see. The motor points this way and the gases escape that way, therefore I'm pointing it across. That away. Yeah, horizon looks good. Okay, we got 8.5 to tick. somewhere along the line, I think I'll trim this maneuver just for the hell of it. Would it be a good time to do it, Buzz? Is it 8 minutes prior? You don't care when I do it, do you?
No, I probably would be after we run the gimbals around.
Oh, yeah. All right. You're right. Okay.
Beautiful looking horizon. It's hard to describe. It's worth seeing. It really is. God, it has an eerie look to it. It's not a horizon, it's just a band. You won't be able to see it if you don't stand that far away from the
way. Which way?
This way. Fuck that. Oh, yeah. It's pretty stupid. It was really eerie when it first came.
You gotta look through the part of the window there, isn't
it? Yeah. And the way the Terminator is, you don't see a whole moon at all. You just see a planet.
I was looking at it upside down for a while.
Yeah, and then that scares you, because that says you're going retrograde, right?
Well, see, if it's upside down, you're going backwards.
Yeah. It wasn't...
Okay. It looks good, I'll tell you. All right, we're coming up on bus side time. We got a little over 650 little ticks. Yes, sir? Whenever you are, it's about 6 minutes.
On, verified.
Okay.
3-3. On. Well, then I am.
All right.
Okay. CDC servo power 1 to AC-1.
1 to AC-1.
2 to
AC-2.
And first control power on.
On.
Rotation control power normal. Number 2, AC.
AC.
Arm rotation controller number 2.
Arm.
So far so good.
Okay, when do you want the gimbal motors on?
Oh, about 5 and a half minutes.
Yeah, it's right now.
Right now?
Okay. Comes pitch 1, ready?
No, wait a minute.
Okay.
Go, pitch 1.
Pitch 1, mark it.
Got it.
Yaw 1, mark it.
Got it.
Okay.
Okay, place controller clockwise.
Clockwise.
Verify no MTBC.
Verify.
Gimbal motor pitch 2, yaw 2 on.
Pitch 2, mark it.
Got it.
Yaw 2, mark it.
Got it.
Okay.
Set DPI trim.
All right, what are they on the fan? Let's see, they're plus...
minus on pitch, minus 0.6.
Okay, minus 0.6, very good.
Plus 6.6.
And plus 6.6. Okay, Neil, those look good to you, they look good to me.
Minus 0.6
and plus 0.6. Okay, DPI set.
Verify MTBC.
Okay. MTBC verified. I'm going to trim now. Proceed to trim.
Do you like plus right? Just point on the right line.
Yes.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah,
we're coming up on the
side of your eyes.
Okay. Okay.
Verify MTBC.
Verify.
Translation controller neutral.
Neutral.
DPI return 0-0.
It does.
Rot control power normal number 2 to AC-DC.
AC-DC.
Spacecraft control CMC.
CMC.
Tramp.
We did.
Okay. VMAG mode 3 to at 1 rate 2.
At 1 rate 2.
Enter.
Enter.
Verify CMC.
CMC verified. Auto verified.
Proceed.
Okay, for the gimbal drive. Up. Down, 0. Up, down, 0. Okay, standing by for packed off and yakko. Mark it. Good trim.
Rotation control power direct to main A, main B.
Main A, main B. FDM helium valves, two of them. Verified auto. Climate cycle off. Okay, limit cycle's off. FDAI scale 50-50. 50-15. Okay, wait for 2 minutes for Delta B thrust A.
2 minutes to get our eyes and check at 10 degrees.
Yep, and sneaking up on there, looks pretty darn good. Looks like we're darn near there. 25 seconds.
Just about midnight. Houston Town.
Yep. Okay, coming up on 2 minutes, and this damn horizon check is going to be, would you believe, perfect.
I hope so.
Fantastic. First time I've ever gotten a perfect horizon check. Spent too many hours in a simulator looking for an unreal horizon. All right, horizon check passes.
Beautiful.
2 minutes to go.
Press A to normal.
Delta V
controller arm.
Okay, Delta V thrust A normal. Standby for a malfunction. It's not there. Good to go.
Probably get the sun in your window on this burn.
Yeah, I believe it. A sunny
controller number two arm.
Just practicing. Rotational hand controller number two is arm.
All right.
LH is going to be 16 seconds to speed jet.
Tape recorder is going to command reset. High bit rate.
Apollo control, we're now less than 30 seconds from the time at which transverse injection is scheduled. The burn to start Apollo 11 on its trajectory back to Earth.
Standby for Ali.
We're now 15 seconds from the scheduled ignition time. That burn will last about 2 minutes 28 seconds and consume 10,000 pounds of propellant. The crew should be burning at this time. Of course, that maneuver is performed on the backside of the moon. We have no data from the spacecraft here in mission control at this time. We don't know how the burn went for about another 10 minutes, which is the time at which we're scheduled to reacquire Apollo 11. During the course of this burn, the spacecraft will increase its speed by about 3,280 feet per second, or about 2,240 miles per hour.
Thank you, contact net one.
Howdy, Chuckle.
Guam. Roger, send out for a team check. Houston, contact testing.
One,
2, 3, 4. 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Test out.
Houston, contact, honey, settle that one.
Go ahead.
100% on team.
Roger.
This is Guam, contact, 100%
team.
Good modulation. How would you like the bogus configured?
Honey, settle in Guam. We will have the bogus and the CSM downlink.
Honeycycle Wilco.
Okay.
Guam, roger.
Okay, good. This is
Honeysuckle on Guam, this is Houston contact, here go.
Honeysuckle, roger. Bomb, roger.
Go. And 2 minutes, mark it. It's the end of that roll dead band, it really comes crisply back. Okay, chamber pressure's falling off a little bit.
Transverse injection should be completed in about 10 seconds from now.
10 seconds left.
Okay, yeah, we don't care about the chamber pressure. We're not. Like, watch yourself or brace yourself. Standing by for engine
on. Should
off.
Be shut down
and we
now.
Should have shut down at this time.
Okay.
Shut at this down. Point, Apollo 11.
Four.
I should be traveling at a speed of about 8,660 feet per second, or about 5,900 miles per hour.
Look at what we got.
And should be on its way back to Earth.
Check it out.
Headed for a splash down in the Pacific Ocean at 195 hours, 18 minutes.
Okay. Pitch one, off. Yaw one, off.
With a successful burn, we should reacquire Apollo 11
off.
In 7 minutes
yaw
and 20 seconds
off.
From now.
GBC server power 1 and 2 off.
Off, off.
Left tires coming on. Proceed.
Beautiful.
Well, action point two. Action V to point two.
Action V. So that's F.
Yeah.
Okay, and Z is down. Okay, then, no. You want to record those five balls?
Record it.
Five balls plus .0, call it .08. It was hanging on .07 for a while, and it was zeroed and down. I give them, or it was one-tenth down, plus one-tenth. Now it's on zero. Shit. I can't read those residuals. They dance all over the place.
Okay, the residuals were .1, 3.9, and .2.
Beautiful burn, eh? Yes, I love you. You are a jewel.
Right, EMS function on.
EMS function on. Stand by.
EMS mode 3 to rate 2. And dead band max.
3 to rate 2, dead band max.
SDS pitch 1, pitch 2, yaw 1, yaw 2, open?
They're open.
Proceed.
I think you did that already. Mm-hmm. Hey, are you going to proceed on these?
Yeah.
Okay. Where do we go, Pooh? Get the high gain?
We want, yeah, Pooh's good, and we want a burp 48.
Yeah, get the
burp 43.
So I'm going to go to SDS and pitch up in these.
Now we're at other space sectors.
Okay, we're in Pooh. Now who wants what? Bird
48? Yeah, Bird. Okay. I don't know. I don't.
Well, it says change the spacecraft weight.
Yeah, up there. Well,
just
like
go through it.
101 to okay. How you get it? It hasn't changed. Okay, we've done that.
All the
jack service module, RCS.
I've done that.
Okay.
Done that.
Bird 83. Here comes Buzz's statement. Bird 83! Da-dum-de-dum-de-dum. Operator.
You don't have to do it.
Okay.
Look at that, will you?
Yeah, beautiful. This thing is beauty. It's a good
Well,
Okay, we got visually acquire moon, take pictures, and then you got a P-52 to do.
For
some unknown reason.
We have another damn program we can call on. The only way to do it is to do a low 66.
How are you doing, Mike? Taking pictures of
it. Oh, I don't know. Wait for the term, I guess.
We got some pictures out of that
here. Just grabbing things. Mary, you've been four, five, six, just like that, right?
Here's a ring that's hidden somewhere.
I wonder what.
You want to take pictures out of that? Go ahead. Let's just set up that
stick window, please.
Set up that tape and let it do its thing. It's still got a long way to go for it.
All right, Natalie, we want black and white color, 250 or 80. I got all options over here.
Oh, we'll probably want to. How many cameras?
Let me have. Yeah, how many cameras? Sure, one camera, but I guess.
Yeah, well.
Well, let's take some color and.
The 80, right?
Yeah, I think you want to go.
Let me know when I'm in a good attitude to stop this fish. How about right now?
How are you doing?
I'm rolling.
Before.
What do we roll for?
I was off and rolling, trekking back to where it should have been.
This is Apollo Control. We're now less than 1 minute from reacquiring Apollo 11. When last we heard from the spacecraft, all systems were looking very good, and we were in very good shape for the trans-Earth injection maneuver. At this point, Apollo 11 should be about 10,000 pounds lighter and on its way back to Earth. We're now 32 seconds from reacquiring. We'll stand by for communications with the spacecraft.
Anybody got any flight greetings they want to make to Houston?
Best
turn I've ever seen in my life, I'll tell
you. And just you guys have seen
two good ones today.
AOS. And there's the cue. We have acquisition of signal. And we have data right on schedule.
Not quite. It's far enough.
Right.
Well, maybe
yeah, I got
it.
Zero wind. Minus 0.7 minus 0.2.
Upside down. Turn the camera upside down. And look right.
Apollo 11, Houston, how did it go? Over.
Tell to open up the LRL doors, Charlie.
Roger, we got you coming home. It's well stocked.
Okay, burn status. Delta dig was zero. Burn time was 2+30. They had angle, delta ATX after trim was 0.1, VGY 0.9, VGZ 0.1, delta VC minus 17.9er, fuel 10.6, aux 10.4, unbalanced minus 50.
Roger, copy, Neil. Sounds good to us. And Apollo 11 Houston, all your systems look real good to us. We'll keep you posted.
All right. Thank you, Charlie boy. Looking good here. That was a beautiful burn. They don't come any finer.
Roger. Apollo 11 Houston, I wondered if you compared your state vector after TEI with the one in the limb slides, over.
Yes, sir. That
looked
very nice.
Houston, looking at your Bank Bravo nitrogen tank, it didn't leak a bit, didn't leak a bit this time, over.
Roger, look good here. Chamber pressure was hanging in there around 100, the latter part of the burn, it started oscillating a little bit and got down a little bit below 100.
Roger.
96 or so.
Roger.
Most of the conversation so far has been from Neil Armstrong and Mike Collins. That last comment came from Collins. Our first report after acquisition was from Neil Armstrong. That trans-earth injection burn was very close to nominal. At this time, we show the spacecraft traveling at a speed of 7,603 feet per second, the velocity already beginning to drop off. And we're at an altitude of 445 nautical miles now from the moon. Thank you. This is Apollo Control. We now show the spacecraft traveling at 7,378 feet per second, altitude 568 nautical miles. The next order of business will be to get the crew to sleep. Flight Director Gene Kranz requested his flight controllers prior to acquisition of signal to review their procedures and to take as many steps as possible to get the crew to sleep as soon as possible. There will be a press conference in the Building 1 auditorium, and we estimate the time on that at about 12:30 Central Daylight Time. And our LEM telecommunications engineer reports that we've just had acquisition of signal from Eagle, which is still in lunar orbit. The last fix that we had on Eagle's orbit showed an apogee of 64.1 and a apocynthian rather of 64.1 and a paracynthian of 54.4 nautical miles. The spacecraft altitude has now climbed to almost 700 nautical miles from the moon. We show a weight of 26,510 pounds, about 10,000 pounds less than what we had, actually about 1,100 or 11,000 pounds. Let's correct that, about 10,100 pounds less than what we had prior to the trans-Earth injection burn.
Apollo 11, Houston, would you give us Poonix SIP? We got a ResNet for you, over.
Okay.
Thank you. Hello, Apollo 11, Houston, we got the load in. You can go back to block, over.
We're there.
Roger.
This is Apollo Control. The flight dynamics officer reports that the burn was very nominal. Almost precisely as planned, the burn duration was about 3 seconds long, but the velocity change was almost precisely what we had been expecting. At the present time, Apollo 11 is 1,076 nautical miles from the moon. The velocity continuing to drop off, down now to 6,698 feet per second. Thank you. This is Apollo Control at 136 hours, 44 minutes. Apollo 11 is now 3,720 nautical miles from the moon and traveling at a speed of 5,367 feet per second. During the press conference, we accumulated about 4 minutes of taped conversation with the crew. The crew reports at this time that they are completing taking pictures and getting ready to realign their guidance system platform. We'll pick up the tape conversations and then stand by for any following live communications with the crew. We anticipate that they will be shortly beginning their pre-sleep checklist in preparation for a well-deserved rest period.
Hello, Apollo 11, Houston. I wondered if during the TE operation you utilized the oxidizer flow valve on the pugs, over.
Yes, we did. Based on your very excellent briefing, I was expecting the thing to continue desiring increase the whole time. So we started out with it in increase, and I saw that pretty quickly crossed the line and started falling about 6 to 7% behind. So I was still expecting it to move up, then I went down to full decrease and brought it back down to a difference of 2% over.
Right, thank you very much, Buzz.
0.2%, I'm sorry.
Right, thank you. Apollo 11, Houston, you can go to PTC attitude and torque at your and do the P-52 and torque at your convenience, over.
Okay, we got to take some more pictures, Charlie. Is there any constraint normally on staying here for a while?
No, sir.
Thank you.
Go ahead, 11, over.
How's that tracking look, or is it too early to tell?
Stand by, Mike. Apollo 11, Houston, Fido's are looking at the data. It's too early to tell yet exactly. It's looking real good so far. We'll have you some answers shortly on trajectory, over.
What Fido is that?
It's Jay Green.
Howdy, Jay.
11, Houston, we have a DAP CSM update for you.
Go ahead.
Roger, CSM weight, Mike, 26370, over.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome. Apollo 11, Houston, we've taken your onboard vector and propagated it forward, and it's looking real good. We only got about 24 minutes of tracking now, and it really too early to tell on the radar, over.
Roger,
hello, Apollo 11, Houston. Mike, did you notice any transients at ignition on TEI, over?
Yeah, that transients were more noticeable than on previous burns, Charlie. I just wrote it off to the back. We had a light command module, but there was considerable roll activity, which dampened down after the first 20 seconds, I would guess, of the burn, but there was also some pitch and yaw activity. I don't believe it was abnormal. It seemed to be dead banding rather crisply in roll, plus or minus about 8 degrees either side of center line. And after the first couple of, after the first 20 seconds or so, the gimbals were quiet and pitch and yaw were relatively quiet. Before that, there was some oscillation, but mostly just in rates. Total attitude hung in there pretty well.
Roger, thank you much. We were looking at the playback and we saw some things at right at startup. We'll be back with you later on that.
Okay.
Apollo 11, Houston, have you finished taking pictures, over?
We're just finishing up, Charlie.
Roger.
About to get started on a B-52 here pretty soon.
Copy.
Another 8 or 9 hours.
This is Apollo Control. That brings us up to date with the taped conversation. We'll stand by for any further live communication from the crew before they begin their sleep period. We've gotten some preliminary figures from the flight dynamics officer on that trans-earth injection burn. After a review of the telemetry data, and it shows that our change in velocity was nominal, 3,283.5 feet per second. We also show a nominal burn time of 2 minutes 28 seconds. The crew reported the burn time about 2 to 3 seconds long. Based on their onboard data, the ground data shows the burn to have been just about nominal. Based on the preliminary tracking, it would appear that the splashdown would occur almost precisely as predicted or planned in the flight plan. That would be at 195 hours, 18 minutes, 40 seconds ground elapsed time. And we would expect that splashdown time to change somewhat during the trans-Earth coast. Particularly as the need or lack of need for mid-course corrections becomes more apparent with additional tracking. At this time, Apollo 11 is 4,086 nautical miles from the moon and traveling at almost precisely 1 mile per second, 5,283 feet per second, and that's just updated to 5,280 feet per second.
Apollo 11, Houston, you can crank up on the PTC at any time, over.
All right, go.
Apollo 11, Houston.
Go ahead, Houston.
Right, 11, this is the regional Capcom. Congratulations on an outstanding job. You guys have really put on a great show up there. I think it's about time you powered down and got a little rest, however. You've had a mighty long day here. Hope you're all going to get a good sleep on the way back. We'll look forward to seeing when you get back here. Don't fraternize with any of those bugs en route, except for the Hornet.
Okay. Thank you, boss. We're looking forward to a little rest and a restful trip back, and see you on the weekend there.
Right, you've earned it.
That exchange was between Donald K. Deeks Layton, Director of Flight Crew Operations at the Manned Spacecraft Center, and astronaut Neil Armstrong.
Hello, Apollo 11 Houston. We'd like you to turn off O2 tank number one, heaters over.
It's on, thank you.
Roger. Hello, Apollo 11 Houston. For your information, the LGC and Eagle just went belly up after 7 hours, over.
Okay, very good. This was death of a real winner, sir. Charlie, we're going to rotate about pitch 270 degrees on the way home, vice 1 or 090 on the way out, right?
Right, sir.
Okay, Air 49 maneuver to that attitude is in progress.
Roger. Again, please, Neil, you were breaking up. We missed that, over.
Okay, this is crew status report, radiation CDR 11017, EMP 10019er, LMP 09020, no medication.
Roger, thank you. And we didn't get a crew status report from you this morning. Wondered if you could give us an estimate of sleep last night, over.
Right here. Okay, we'll take a guess at Charlie and try to get an equivalent amount and call it CDR3 and LMP4.
Right, thank you very much.
You want the fan cycle thing, right?
That's affirmative, and we'd like you to disable quads Charlie and Delta. Over.
Charlie and Delta.
Apollo 11 Houston, if it's convenient, we'd like to go through your onboard readout, over. Oh, excuse me, that's on the flight plan 3102. We'd like BATS and RCS, over. Copy it. Roger, go ahead.
Bat Charlie 370, Pyro Bat A 370, Bat B 370, RCS 55, 65, 64, and 62, over.
Roger, we copy all that. Thank you much. Apollo 11 Houston, a couple of questions for the moonwalkers if you got a second, over.
Go ahead.
Roger, Neil, we're seeing some temperature rises on the passive seismic experiment that are a little higher than normal, and we're wondering if you could verify the deployed position. We understand it's about 40 feet from the limb in the 11 o'clock position, over.
Now it's about in the 9 or 9:30 position, and I'd say it's about 50 or 60 feet.
Roger, copy. Also, did you notice, was any indication of any dust cloud as you listed off, over?
Not very much. There was quite a bit of capstone and parts of the limb that went out in all directions, usually for great distances, as far as I could tell. But I don't remember seeing anything of a dust cloud to speak of.
Roger, I understand all you could see was parts of the limb going out. What was your first comment, over?
I don't remember. Just could see capstone and other parts of the limb staging, scattering all around the area for great distances, but I didn't see much dust.
Roger, thank you very much. Apollo 11, could you keep me honest on the lithium hydroxide changes? When do you have the next one scheduled for? Stand by. Apollo 11, Houston, Mike on that canister. We had you due to change one at 1:33 before TEI, and it's on page 399. The next one we got is at 1:47. Over.
Okay.
Apollo 11, Houston, we'd like to extend our damping period for another 5 minutes, let the rates get way down, over.
11, roger.
This is Apollo Control at 137 hours, 27 minutes. At this time, Apollo 11 is traveling at a speed of about 4,982 feet per second. It is about 5,900 nautical miles from the moon and about 198,900 nautical miles from Earth. A short while ago, you heard Neil Armstrong make a few descriptive comments of the scene on the lunar surface at the time the LEM ascent stage lifted off. Armstrong reported seeing very little dust, but quite a bit of debris from the LEM. He referred to the Kapton, which is a plastic-like insulation material, generally silver or gold in color, which is found on the outside surfaces of the LEM. Now, we also had a report at 136 hours, 54 minutes, about 40 minutes or so ago, that the LEM guidance computer had finally stopped putting out any data. And that was about 7 hours, 13 minutes after the primary guidance system was deprived of the coolant in a test of how long the system would continue to operate without coolant. The platform apparently began to become unusable after about 4 hours, and the computer itself finally gave up after about 7 hours and 13 minutes. Both items going considerably longer than had previously been predicted. The lunar module ascent stage still in lunar orbit. We're continuing to get data from it. All other systems appear to be functioning well at this time. The LEM orbit we show is currently 64.4 nautical miles for height of apocynthian, 54.4 nautical miles for paracynthian. The LEM is in its 23rd revolution. Now here's a call to the crew.
Over.
Roger, Charlie. I'd like to bring you up to date on our chlorination status. In compartment B4, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 for correction. We have 8 pockets for chlorine and buffer ampules, of which, let me correct that. We have 7 pockets, which one is empty and always has been empty, leaving 6 remaining. And the other side over there in B7, we have another container with 7 pockets. So we have a total of 7 plus 6, and those are filled with 6 chlorines and 7 buffers. Now, I've been using 1 chlorine and 1 buffer per day, which at this point in time, prior to this chlorination I'm about to do, leaves me 1 chlorine and 2 buffers. Seems to me I'm 1 chlorine short, and that being the case, I'd like to ask your advice on postponing this chlorination using the last container until some later date, like maybe tomorrow. Over.
Roger, we copy, Mike. Stand by.
Okay.
Apollo 11, Houston, check in A1, Mike, and see what you can find in there, over. We think you might have some more chlorine up in A1, over. Hello, Apollo 11, Houston. Apollo 11, Houston, do you read? You're breaking up, over. Roger 11, you're breaking up. Mike, please look in compartment A1. We think there might be some more chlorine up there, over. Houston, reading you about one by, over.
Houston.
11 Houston, we're having a downlink problem. The reason we can't read you, we're switching sites. Stand by. Hello, Apollo 11 Houston. How do you read now? Over.
Fine.
All right, you're 5x92, Mike. Thank you much. Did you copy that about A1 on the chlorine?
Eureka.
How about that, sports fan? Apollo 11 Houston, we're having a little trouble getting the yaw rate damped out to appropriate value. We'd like y'all to be quiet like mice for a couple of minutes, and let's see if that'll help it out. Over. Eleven Houston, you did great work there. We're ready to spin it up. Over. Eleven Houston, did you copy? Over.
Yeah, we read
Roger, Charlie, would you stand by a minute?
Roger, no hurry. Houston, shift change time here. White team, bid you good night. We'll see you tomorrow. Over.
Night, Charlie. Thank you. Night, Charlie. Thank you. Adios.
Adios. Thanks again for a great show, you guys.
Thanks for a great job down there.
This is Apollo Control at 137 hours, 52 minutes. Apollo 11 crew has signed off for the night, starting a long, well-deserved rest period. Duration of the rest period is programmed for 10 hours. However, the wake-up time is not critical. It's very likely we'll let them sleep till they wake up of their own accord. At this time, Columbia is 7,045 nautical miles away from the moon, headed toward home at a velocity of 4,868 feet per second.